Oh, Jesus, can you help me now?
Jesus, can you help me now?
Oh, Jesus, can you help me now?
Jesus, can you help me now?
Oh, Jesus, can you help me now? No, I never felt so alone. I remember when I was wild and free.
Jesus was actually a song I wrote the day my grandfather died. I was driving, my mom had called me and she told me that he had passed. And I was, we drove to the hospital. I didn't know he was dead yet. And we got there and it turned out he had passed. And I was just thinking about his life. And you know, he was somebody who came to sort of a faithful life, I think, along the way. And I was just thinking about how a lot of people, when they call out because they know they need it. That was not a song for me at all. It was a song that was for him. And a lot of times, you know, maybe these spirit voices do come through us and we have a direct connection to that through the people who, you know, are, you know, we've come through, which is obviously partly your grandparents. And I kind of felt like that was coming from him.
But now the world has changed.
I listen to a lot of gospel music, like I listen to a lot of Thomas Dorsey and I listen to a lot of Stanley Brothers and stuff, and I don't know, there's just some, there's a directness to it. Even the Soul Stir stuff and the Sam Cooke stuff from the early Soul Stir stuff, really, it really moves me. It's just so powerful and it's so raw, like you said. It's like there's a certain thing about religion and religious music today that's so not raw anymore. And I wonder why it got so glossy. Like, when did we stop wanting to get to the root?
Take it from the top on the verse, I'ma ask you. Now, Jesus, can you help me now?
Jesus, can you help me now?
Oh, Jesus, can you help me now?
Jesus, can you help me now?
Oh, Jesus, can you help me now? No, I never.